Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Enjoy Learning Computer Science. To watch my previous videos, watch my YouTube channel. To get notified for my new videos, subscribe to my YouTube channel Enjoy Learning Computer Science. In this video, we are going to discuss about the different network protocols and the abbreviations of the network terminology. So what is a protocol? A protocol is an agreement between the communicating parties on how communication is to be proceeded. So it means a set of rules that governs a network. I'll tell you an example. If there are two persons, person A and person B, and they are talking simultaneously without listening to each other. They are not waiting to listen to them. At the same time, they are talking, keeps on talking. And just imagine the condition, it will be a chaos. Both of them will not be able to understand anything. So to avoid this complications, we can give a rule stating that only one person can speak at a time, and after completing the first person, the second person will be able to speak, and this first person will be listening, and so on. So we can implement certain rules to avoid the chaos. So this protocol means the set of rules that governs a network. So whatever nodes are connected in a network to communicate between among one node to the other node, they have to follow a set of rules, and those rules are known as protocols. So to exchange messages or information or data among two computers in a network, protocols has to be followed, rules has to be followed. So protocol is a set of rules that govern the network. Different types of protocols and uses. There are different types of protocols. The first protocol is the HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. By the name itself, you can understand it is related to hypertext. It is used to govern hypertext. So set of rules for transferring hypertext on WWW, that is World Wide Web. So hypertext means it can be text, graphics, image, sound, audio, video, etc. combination. So hypertext transfer protocol, that is HTTP, is a set of rules for transferring hypertext on WWW. The next one is the TCP/IP, that is the Transmission Control Protocol, or the Internet Protocol. So there are two protocols: Transmission Control Protocol and Internet Protocol. So TCP is one of the main protocols in TCP/IP networks. The IP protocol deals only with packets, but TCP enables to establish a connection and exchange streams of data between two computers. Okay, so what is packets? So a data which is sent from one computer, a message which is sent from one computer to the other computer, will be divided into chunks of messages called packets, will be divided into small informations called packets, and each packet will be having the destination IP address as well as a sequence number. Okay, so why do we need the sequence number? Because these packets will be reached to the destination computer in random, and then it has to be arranged in order. So to arrange in order, this sequence number will be used to arrange the packets in order. And the IP address of the destination computer is to receive, to deliver to the proper computer node. Okay, so IP protocol deals only with packets, but TCP enables to establish a connection and exchange streams of data. So TCP works with the IP, right? So how computers send packets to each other, both of them together will do the work. Now TCP at the receiver end side collects all packets, and then it will arrange in sequential order. So TCP is a reliable stream delivery service that will guarantee that all the packets are received in the destination computer in the correct order. So IP is the Internet Protocol is responsible for delivering packets from the source to the destination computer in the shortest route. So that is known as transmission control protocol, internet protocol. So it is used for communication over the internet. Then the next one is FTP, that is the file transfer protocol. Now FTP is the simplest and the most secure way to exchange files over the internet. So the main objectives of this FTP are transmitting and sharing of files, then to transfer data reliably and efficiently, then indirect or implicit use of remote computers. Okay, so FTP is file transfer protocol, which is used to exchange files over internet. So FTP is most commonly used to download a file from the server using the internet, then or to upload a file to a server. The next one is the SMTP, that is simple mail transfer protocol, which is used for sending mails. But by the name itself, you can understand it is used to send mails. So SMTP is used for sending email messages to other networks or computers. It handles only outgoing messages and not incoming messages. And you have to be very clear that SMTP does not create messages, but it helps in forwarding messages between client computers, client servers. And the next one is POP3, that is Post Office Protocol 3, or IMAP, Internet Message Access Protocol. This is used for receiving emails. It is a simple and standard method to access mailbox and download all the messages to the local computers. So the user can receive messages with the help of POP protocol. So the advantage is that once the messages are downloaded, an internet connection is not necessary to read the mail. You all must be aware of these things. So POP3, that is Post Office Protocol, is used for receiving emails. Then VOIP, that is Voice Over Internet Protocol, that is used for voice calls over internet. And Telnet is used to log on to the remote computer system. Then IRC is Internet Relay Chat, which is mainly used for text chat on internet. And SIP, that is Session Initiation Protocol, or H323, that is used for video chatting and conferencing. A Session Initiation Protocol and H323 are used for video chat for conference. Now let's see the abbreviations of important network terminologies. The first one is SLIP, that is Serial Line Internet Protocol. PPP is Point-to-Point Protocol. HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. URL, Uniform Resource Locator. HTML, Hypertext Markup Language. DHTML, Dynamic Hypertext Markup Language. WLL, Wireless in Local Loop. GSM, Global System for Mobile Communication. CDMA, Code Division Multiple Access. TDMA, Time Division Multiple Access. SIM, Subscribers Identity Module. SMS, Short Messaging Service. MMS, Multimedia Messaging Service. EDGE, Enhanced Data Rates for Global Evolution. IMAP, Internet Message Access Protocol. Wi-Fi, Wireless Fidelity. IPR, Intellectual Property Rights. WWW, World Wide Web. XML, Extensible Markup Language. PHP, Hypertext Preprocessor. ASP, Active Server Pages. JSP, Java Server Pages. FLOSS, FiberLibr and Open Source Software. GNU, not Unix. OSI, Open Source Initiative. FSF, Free Software Foundation. W3C, World Wide Web Consortium. So these are some of the abbreviations that is from the chapter Computer Networks. There are more abbreviations. So these videos are just to revise everything. So please go through the videos and read the textbook one and revise properly. Thanks for watching my video.